Hello, student. This script is demonstration of the analysis of statically indeterminate tasks. This task has the picture here. It has the roller at C, has the pin at A, and also has the pin at E. So by this formation, this task could have the reaction of 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And this task has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 members. So the task gonna have, what you know, the unknown forces and reactions. Each member gonna have one unknown of internal force, okay, and the reaction at 5. So we have this one of 6 bar plus 5 reaction. So the unknown is gonna be 11. And what, how many equation do we have? Each choice of the task, which is the frictionless pin, are going to have 2 equation of equilibrium. And when you time the number of joints, you're going to have the total equation to solve this task. We have 2 times 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 times 5. That is going to be 10. Now, what we have, the degree of indeterminacy is going to be 11 minus 10. That is going to be 1. So this task is going to be statically indeterminate task with the degree of freedom equal to 1. Now, we're going to set up one unknown force as the redundance basis on the consistent deformation. And most of the time, the redundant going to be kind of an isolated force. So this time they set the C, the reaction at C, as the redundant. So if they set that, so our C sub Y gonna be the redundant. And now, when you put the C sub Y as the redundant, you will take the roller out, and then you put the reaction at point C, which is the redundant, act at point C. Now, so first, let the C sub Y as the redundant force. And second, okay, we going to find the compatibility condition at C in Y or vertical direction. Now, we're going to do what? We're going to use the principle by using the principle of superposition. We can separate the task in two cases. Now, we're going to separate this one. The first task is going to be the primary task. This is going to be the primary task, which is subjected to P equal to 10 kilonewton. So this is going to subjected to the giving force of 10 kilonewton. This task has the stiffness of 20,000 kilonewton meters square per square meter. So all of them have the same stiffness. And this is going to pass, okay, pass another test. That's going to subject it to the redundant. So this is going to be another test. And is subjected to the redundant. So this is going to have the pin and has the free, okay, at point C. So at point C, this is going to have the C sub Y. And when you separate into this one, this is primary thrust subjected to the given load. This is going to be the thrust subjected to the redundant force C sub Y. Okay, and what happened is, under the application of the force, the primary thrust will deform like this. And this thrust will deform by this point, gonna move from C to C prime. And the thrust supposed to have the deformation, okay, upward like this one. And what we have is, this is going to be the deformation, the vertical deformation at C. Since C sub Y is unknown, usually we just set C sub Y equal to 1, then this is going to be the deflection at C in the vertical direction, if you like, okay, when the force apply at C. And if the total force is C sub Y, so the total vertical deflection gonna be F sub C, C, C sub Y, okay, by considering the deformation of the thrust, okay, and the vertical displacement at C. So we have what? We have this one, 0. And let the downward is positive. This is going to be the delta C. And then it's going to be delta, the deflection at point C in the vertical direction. And it's going to be the minus, this is upward, F sub C, C and C sub Y. So your C sub Y is going to be delta sub C divided by F sub C, C. And the problem give us the deflection over here of 9.761 millimeter downward. So by doing this, actually we can determine it, 9.761 millimeter, and divided by F sub CC. This is gonna be the compatibility condition at C in the vertical direction. And now the problem is, we got to define the deflection, right? So the third 1, 2, and 3, we determine the force displacement relationship. Actually, this one is only F sub CC by using the
By using the what?
By using the method of virtual work. Okay. If you use the method of virtual work, and let's see if you like to determine this, we got to what? We got to put one unit force act in the same direction of F sub CC. So that means you're going to push this one at point C by 1.0. And then this 1.0 times this real displacement. So it's going to be the what's so called the external virtual work. That is going to be equal to internal virtual work. And external virtual work is 1.0 times this one times F sub CC, and it's going to be equal to this one unit of applied force produce the internal force of N, and this N is time the deformation here. Okay, the deformation here also can determine from the elongation or the shortening of this, and you know that the deformation or the shortening here can be determined from the Hooke's law, and it's going to be n over ae. Okay, and now what we have is this is going to be summation of small n, sorry, nl over e, at the same time nl over ae. And what we have, since the C sub Y is going to be equal to 1, so the N that's due to this one will change to small n. So this one is going to be the summation of N square L over AE like this. Okay, and this is going to be the equation for the method of virtual work. Okay, and also if you like to determine delta sub C, you do the same thing. This is 1.0, apply this. You're going to have 1.0 and then time delta sub C, which is going to be equal to summation. This is going to be N. Okay, N because of it. 10 kilonewton, then because of P equal to 10 kilonewton, so it's going to be small n and capital N time L over AE. Okay, and you also can determine this 9.761 if you put into this equation. Okay, anyway, we got to find N, so we set up the task here. And we are looking for the N. Okay, we have 5 centimeter. Let's say for 5 meter, 5 meter for 2.5 centimeter. It's a scale like this. And this one is 4. This is going to be about 2. And this is going to be 1. So your task is going to be like this. This is pin, and you have this member and have the pin also here. Now, the task is going to look like this. Okay, and the force of 1.0 apply here to determine N. So we going to find the force in the truss, TRUSS truss member, which is the N. Okay, this is going to be A B, C, and D, and E. This is going to be 5 meter, 5 meter, and this is going to be 4 meter, right? So this is going to be 4 meter. We're going to determine the in. Now, what is this? This is going to be 2 meter, and you also can determine the theta here. So the theta here is going to be 10 of 2 over 5, which is going to be 21.8 degree. Okay, you can pause the video and try to check the number what we have here. And from this, we can apply the concept of zero force member. Do we have some zero force member here? So we have a zero force member. Okay, zero force member, we have F sub BD equal to zero. If BD is zero, see this is going to be in the same horizontal direction. So you also have F sub AB equal to F sub, this is BC. Now, okay, this is a good thing of zero force member. It help you to reduce the calculation work. Now, we are here. Okay, we have this one for point C. We have this one for X, this one for Y, and 1.0 apply here. That is going to be 1.0 here. And due to this, what should be for this one? Okay, this is going to be downward, right? Because when you project this, it's going to balance the 1.0. And since you project this one, it's going to take on the right. So this portion is going to take on the left. And this is going to be F sub BC. And this is going to be F sub CD with the angle here of 21.8. And now, you will determine this by what? By summation of F sub X? No, F sub X, you're going to have two unknown equations. So summation of F sub Y equal to zero. And then you're going to have this one downward. So downward is positive. You have F sub CD, you're going to project in vertical direction, psi 21.8 degree. And then you get this one equal to 1.0. So your F sub CD is going to be 1 divided by psi 21.8. That is going to be 2.693. Okay, that is going to be your F sub CD. F sub CD. So you get this one for compression. Minus 2.693. Okay, and another one, you have this summation of X sub X equal to zero, and this direction is plus. So you have F sub BC in this one, and it's going to equal to this guy cosine 2.690 cosine 21.8 degree. And now you just put into your calculator, you will get this one of 2.50. Okay, this is for F sub BC, and it's going to be in tension. This is going to be plus 2.5, and this is going to be zero. By doing this, this is also F sub AB equal to F sub BC. This is 2.5. So you got this one. This is plus 2.5. Okay, now you have two more members. DENAD, right? So you put this here, and you have 2.63 here. This is going to be 2.693, and it's in compression. This is the joint of the dock. And then you have the force here, so I believe this one's supposed to be in compression. This is DE, F sub DE. Okay, and you have another one here, so this is up, so this one also point out right in here. That is F sub AD. Okay, and you may have this one, theta, so this one gonna be theta. And this one also theta. Now, you have the total of 2 theta here. You may use the x and y to calculate this, but it's not that convenient to set this x. It's better to set this one as x prime, and this one as the y prime. Okay, if you set like this, this two gonna be in the same direction, and this one can be projected into this direction. Okay, and oh, sorry for this. And then you have this. Okay. Summation of x sub, if I do this, f sub y prime, f sub y prime equal to 0. This is going to be in this direction. Okay, and if you project this, this is going to be in the y prime. So it's going to be f sub ad, and this is cosine, this is going to be psi 2 theta, and this is going to be up, right? There is no force here, equal to 0. So your F sub AD is going to be 0. And if you do the summation of X sub X prime equal to 0, putting this one, you got F sub DE, right? So this is going to be F sub DE, and it's going to be the same as this. So it's going to equal to 2.69. This is 993. Okay, that is going to be F sub DE. So the DE is going to be minus 2.693. And this also be 0. The same thing as this one is 0. Now, you get all the forces that you may like to have. Okay, you have the member, you have the member, you have the member of what? You have the member, many member of AB, AB, BC, C, D, D, E, okay, and A, D, and B, D. Okay, that's all you have for this member. And you also have the L, right? You also have the L. This L is gonna be meter. L in meter, and if possible, please have the horizontal line to separate them like this. Okay, this is 5 meter, this is 5 meter, and this is 2 square plus 5 square and square root of that. It's going to be 5.385, and this is 5.385 and 80, 5.385 and this one 2.0, okay, and the in, and the in, you have the in, small in, okay, this is what, AB plus 2.5, BC plus 2.5, okay, and else, this is minus CD, 2.693, DE minus 2.693, AD is here, is 0, okay, BD is 0, okay, and then you may determine the N square if you like. This is N square. This is a plus 6.25, plus 6.25. This is also plus. This is also plus. 7.252. And this is 0, 0. Okay, and the last one, you may compute the N square L. You just time it, N square time L. That is going to be plus 0, 0. 31.25, 31.25, 39.05, 39.05, and then you get all of this here for the summation. That is going to be 140.6. And now you can determine the F sub CC. So your F sub CC gonna be this N square 140.6 divided by AE. And this is positive, right? So it's gonna be up. And this is in millimeter, if you like. This is gonna be 140.6 divided by 20,000, and you also can see that this is going to be in meter. If you like to answer in millimeter as it was, it's going to be 3.03 millimeter, and this is going to be upward. Okay, that is the result that you may have. And if you prefer, you may do this from this equation. You can see the N is the same as we have the N here. But this one for the capital N, you can check whether what they give us is correct or not. Okay, if you have time, this is zero force member. So if you like, you will have this one for joint D subjected to the force of 10 kilonewton here. And what you have is two force here. You can determine it easily, right? So if you set this one is the X and this one is the Y, so I think this one should have this force here to balance it. This is going to be AD. This is going to be F sub AD. And this is going to be F sub DE. Okay, this is going to be F sub DE. Mm-hmm. And you may know that the angle here is theta, and this one also theta. Now, based upon this, you may use what summation F sub X. You will get this one, summation F sub X equal to 0. You may have this one cos and cosine and cosine. So F sub DE will equal to F sub AD, since they're going to cosine with the same theta. Okay. Okay, f sub de, so you got this is plus. And you may do the summation of f sub y equal to zero. So this time just up is the plus. So this one is up. This one is up. So f, let's say is f equal to f, s to f, up and up. And it's going to psi 21.8 degree. And it's going to equal to 10. Okay, so this one, the f is going to be, this is 10 divided by 2, like 5 divided by psi 21.8 degree. What do you have? 5 divided by 21.8 degree. Psi 21.8, psi. Sorry. 21.8 and psi. 0.3714. Okay, so 5 divided by 0.3714 is going to be 13.463. That is going to be equal to 13.163 kilonewton. This is going to be equal of this. Okay, if you like, you have in here, and you may put this one over here. And what you have is going to be only these two. This one is in comparison, minus 463.463. This is plus 13.463. Only AD and ED. AD and ED. Okay, so the DE is plus 13.463, and this is going to be minus the AD. Okay, 13.463. This is zero. So only one that you have is this. Okay, and this one, and it's going to be delta sub c gonna equal to for the de only for this de 5.38 and minus 2.693 and time this one plus 13.463. Okay, and you may get this divided by AE. Okay, that is the total of this 13.463 times 2.690 times 5.385. Okay, that is 5.385. That is going to be 195.23 and divided by AE, and you're gonna divided by 20. Okay, that is going to be 9.76261. Okay, that's this. So you have this one for 9.76 1 6 10 minus 3 meter. This is cool enough for this is cool enough of 9.761 millimeter. And this is negative. Yeah, this one negative. This one is negative. So this one is positive, is going to have the opposite direction of this. So it's down. So check, you got this result for what given over here. Okay. And now what else you can do? You get this already. That's mean we plug back into this. We gonna determine. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4. Determine the redundant, the redundant d sub c sub y is going to be c sub y, and this is going to equal to 9.761 divided by 7.03 millimeter, and then you get this for 1.39 kilonewton. Okay, this is one of the thing we have C sub Y, and the result is this. So now we may just apply into here. Okay, do the same thing. This is gonna be the thrust. Our thrust, the free body diagram of our thrust. Okay, what we do we have is the 10 kilonewton apply here. 10 kilonewton. And what we have here is 1.39. Okay, this is gonna be A, B, C, D, E. Mm-hmm. To make it more complete, this is going to have the A sub Y. Oh, we also have this for the A sub X. Okay. And this is 5 meter. This is 5 meter. And for this one, actually, is the pin at here, but it's connect directly to the member ED, so this is going to produce the force of F sub ED. Okay, this is going to be theta, and we may also have the E sub X and E sub Y if you like. This is the projection, this is a dashed line. Okay. And what we have, this is 4 meter. Now, you got to determine the force, right? So you may take this one. This is gonna be F sub ED cos 21.8 degree. This is gonna be F sub ED sine 21.8 degree. If you do the summation of the moment, about A equal to 0. Okay, just take some measure of the moment about A equal to 0. And you determine this, right? So just put it is positive. We have what? We have this one times 4. We have F sub ED cosine 21.8 degree. This time 4. That's counterclockwise. This is counterclockwise. And you have this plus 1.39, and this is 10. And you are going to have this one equal to 10 times 5. 10 times 5. And now you can determine F sub D E easily. F sub E D equal to 9.72 kilonewton. And take it up. So this is the T. Okay. Okay. And you may say, if you project this one, so the E sub X is going to be this one, 9.72 and cosine 21.8. And you project this one is the E sub Y. E sub Y equal to 9.72 sine 21.8 degree. So you get the result. You get the result. Okay, E sub X and E sub Y, this is going to be 9.02. Okay, and you may have also for this one going to be 3.61. Okay, now you can go further to determine the A sub X and A sub Y, right? We can do it easily. Okay, let's go further to find this A sub X and A sub Y. Now, just put this one as the E sub X equal to 9.02 kilonewton. And this one E sub Y, 3.61 kilonewton. Now, you do the summation of X sub X equal to 0. And now if you put this one is plus, so your A sub X can be easily A sub X equal to 9.02 kilonewton. Okay, and then you do the summation of F sub Y equal to 0. What you get is this one, right? It's going to be A sub Y plus 1.39. And this one plus 3.61. And then up, this one is downward equal to 10. Okay, and your A sub Y gonna be 10 minus, this is 5. That is going to be 5 kilonewton. Okay, that's for the all the reaction do we have for this. Now, we're going to determine the force in the member. And if you notice between this one and this one, you can determine the F sub CD and F sub ED of this problem easily. Okay, by considering the free body diagram of the joint C, we have, if you do this, we have this one gonna be F sub CD. We have F sub CD equal to, this is 1.39, this is 1.39, and time this, time minus 2.693. And also one F sub BC equal to 1.39, and time this one time plus 2.5. So you got F sub BC of 3.475 kilonewton, and it's going to be in tension. So this is plus 3.475, and this is going to be equal to minus, right? And it's going to be in compression, if you like, 3.743. This is going to be minus 3.743. Now, the concept of zero force members still apply. So this one, this is going to be for zero force member. Okay, this is zero force member. Now, you just determine this, the force of this one and this one due to the 10 kilonewton. Okay, and then if you prefer, it's going to have the compression here. So now, at point D, you have this one, you have this one, you have 10 kilonewton, 3.743 kilonewton. And then you have two more of this. Let's say we have this before, right? When we determine the reaction at this point, it's going to be 9.72. So this is going to be 9.72 kilonewton. So only one that we gonna determine is F sub AD. This one is plus 9.72. And you have this one for F sub AD. And this is going to be 2 theta. 2 times 21.8. You know that. Okay, it's up to you. You may take the consideration about X, Y as before, or you may take this one for the X palm, and this one gonna be the Y palm, and this one Y palm, this gonna be theta. Okay, and it's better to take this one in the X palm direction. So summation of X palm equal to zero. This one is in this direction is plus. So this one F sub AD. That's gonna cause 2 times 31.8, 43.6 degrees. Okay. And this is going to be along this direction, and it's going to equal to 9.72, right? It's going to be this one is up, and plus 3.743, and this one put it. It's going to be this one cosine, this one psi minus 10 psi 21.8 degree. Okay, so now your F sub AD gonna equal to 9.749, and cosine divided by 4, 43.6 degrees. and you get this for 13.46 kilonewton. Okay, and this one is what? This one is compression. So this one is minus 13.46. So that's all we have for this analysis of the thrust. We got the result of this, and then you should put this one into this table. Okay, and then you will have this one for plus 3.475 kilonewton in tension. This also 3.475 kilonewton in tension. And for the CD minus 3.743 kilonewton and in compression. And DE, we know that 9.72. This is 9.72 kilonewton in tension. AD, we just finished this. It's 13.46 kilonewton. That is in compression. And the last one for the BD is 0. Okay, that's all we have for the analysis of this thrust, and you may do it again by yourself. Close everything and try to solve slowly. Try to understand what actually is in this calculation. Try to understand, review your thrust analysis that we take from the InStatic and the Chapter 3. And don't miss it, because if you cannot use the knowledge correctly, the calculation here also going to be incorrect. Okay, do a lot of practice. Okay, end of the clips. Bye.